Hi, this is Viv from Plugin Republic. In this video, we're going to look at how to add custom product options to your WooCommerce products. Custom product options allow you to go beyond basic product listings and offer a more personalized shopping experience. Options allow users to customize your products, choosing add-on fields for their specific requirements. Take a look at the options on this pizza product, or at the engraving options on this bracelet. Product options go beyond standard WooCommerce variations, allowing you to add multiple field types to your products, such as checkboxes, radio buttons, text inputs, swatch selections, even fields to upload files. To add custom product options, you'll need the WooCommerce Product Add-Ons Ultimate plugin. This is the most powerful custom options plugin available for WooCommerce, offering multiple different field types, plus advanced features like conditional logic, global groups and fields, child products, and more. It works with all themes and page builders, and it's easy for developers and non-coders alike. It's also fully documented and supported by our expert team. Let's take a look at a few examples to see how easy it is to add custom product options to your WooCommerce site. Once you've installed and activated the plugin, you can choose to add options to individual products or globally to multiple products. We've got a demo site with over 100 example products. The link is below. For now, let's run through a couple of examples to show how easy it is to set up the plugin. Here's a simple demo product for a bracelet. We'd like to allow the user to add some text to be engraved on the item. So we go into the Product Edit screen and click on the Product Add-ons tab in this section. You can see that we've already created a field here. In this field here, we've entered a field label. And here we've set which field type we want, in this case, a text field. This will add a text input field to the front end, where the user can enter their text to be engraved. For now, that's really all we need to do to create our custom option. The user can enter their text, and when they add the product to the cart, the text is saved as part of the product. When they check out, the text they've entered will be saved as part of the order too, so that both the customer and the store owner will see it. Let's switch back to the edit screen and look at some more options. Let's say that we want to charge extra for the engraving. We can enter a field price here. Even better, we'd like to charge a price per character. So just check the price per character option here. If we save and switch back to the front end again, now you can see that there's a price associated with the field. When we enter some text, the price increases according to how many characters we've entered. There are some fields down here showing the extra costs. We have control over those, so we can decide which ones to display or to hide them all. Let's go back to the edit screen again. What about if we want to restrict the number of characters the customer can enter? We can set a maximum number here. We can check the Show Counter option to show how many characters they're allowed, and we can set options like the number of free characters. If you want to make the field compulsory, that is, ensure that the user enters a value, you can check the Required Field option. Switch to the front end again, and we can see this in action. Even for such a basic custom option like a text field, you can see that it's really easy to set up, but also that it's very powerful with a lot of functionality. Okay, that's a quick intro to some of the core features of Add-ons Ultimate. Take a look at the demo site to see examples for all field types. Now, let's look at some of the other features that the plugin offers. On our first example, we looked at adding custom options to a single product. What about if you want to add the same options to multiple products? You can do this by using global fields. Go to the global group setting under the Product Add-ons menu item and add a group. Groups are collections of custom option fields. You can have as many fields as you like per group. Add a field, In this example, let's just add a simple checkbox to offer the user extra insurance on our products. We can add a price to the field. Now we can decide how many products to display this on. Choose On All Products to display the extra options on every product on your site, or choose to display for specific products, or choose to display for all products within specific categories. Remember, you can create multiple global groups and display them wherever you like. Save, and let's take a quick look at our bracelet product again. You can see the new option here. Let's take a look at some more features for groups. Groups help you organize your custom options, especially if you have a large number of options on the page, and guide the user around the page. In this example, where users can configure different parts of a bicycle, the groups contain options for different parts of the bike. So the user selects options relating to the frame from this section, then clicks through to select some options for the wheels in the next group, and so on. If you like, you can specify that fields in one group must be completed before the user moves to the next group, but this is up to you. Let's take a look at the back end. You can see that it's really simple. Each group contains a certain number of fields, and there's an option here to select the layout of the group. In this example, we've chosen the steps layout, but there are several others, or you can have a standard list view instead. When you open up a group, there are settings for the group title and a description, and you can also choose how fields are displayed within the group, for example in single column, a table, etc. Here you can see a button to add condition. This takes us on to our next feature. Conditions are a really powerful feature in Add-Ons Ultimate. They allow you to decide which options are displayed based on the values that users enter for other options. Let's take a look at a simple example of this in action. In this version of our bracelet product, there's a checkbox here. When the user selects it, another field is displayed. We can see how this works in the edit screen. Our field has a condition assigned. When the checkbox is checked, then this field will be displayed. We can make conditions more complex if we wish by adding multiple conditional statements, and we can apply conditions to both fields and groups. Now let's quickly look at some of the most advanced field types. Switching back to our bicycle product, let's look at the first group. Here we have a field where the user can choose their frame. These frames are displayed as custom options, but they are in fact standalone products themselves. We just pull them into our main bicycle product as child products. We can choose to display these child product options in different ways, with or without a thumbnail, with or without a quantity selector, and so on. Using products as options is extremely powerful. It allows you to upsell products while still keeping track of inventory. Here's a product that the user can configure visually. They can click on these color swatches to update different elements of the product image with their chosen options. When they add the product to their cart, the thumbnail is saved according to their unique configuration. And finally, here's an example of a calculation field. This product allows the user to build a custom window frame. They can enter their width and height, and the plugin will calculate the area needed plus the cost. Calculation fields are really powerful, allowing you to calculate values using formulas. These formulas can include custom inputs, prices, product properties, and other variables. You can use the results of the calculation fields in other fields, or to set product price or dimensions. So that's an introduction to custom product options in WooCommerce. You just need the WooCommerce Product Add-Ons Ultimate plugin. For more information, check out the resources section on the Plugin Republic website, where you'll find dozens of tutorials and case studies. And remember, you can see more examples on the demo site. Thanks for watching, and make sure you hit the like and subscribe buttons.